The American Heart Association wants everyone to learn how to save lives, and that includes how to perform CPR. 7 News' Christine Scarpelli live in Greenville. Well, you've been talking about the Bee Gees music all morning long.
I got it going for you, Fred. Listen, this is a song that should come to mind, maybe even be ready on your phone when you think CPR. CPR week, last day. We want you to know how to do this, not be afraid, right, Doc, to go ahead, put your hands on somebody and possibly save their life. And also, as you go into work this morning, figure out where in the world your AED is. I don't know where ours is at 7 News, but I think it's on the wall somewhere.
Well,
I'll double check.
Hopefully by tonight you will.
There you go. Dr. Senfield here, Bon Secours St. Francis.
Good morning.
Cardiac electrician is kind of how we describe it.
That's essentially what I am.
I love that.
I try, yeah.
Very good.
Yeah.
Easy stuff. Okay, CPR, we got a mannequin. This is an adult, he's on the ground. How did he get here? Is that important?
Well, so, you know, if there's a patient, this is not a real patient, obviously, but if someone is passed out, they're unconscious, a colleague at work, mm-hmm. you're going to want to get them flat on the ground, the back on the ground, and
are you conscious?
You want to do that, but you also want to make sure you call 911.
First step, call 911. Second step, how do we set up for this, Doc?
And then you probably want to take a deep breath, too, if you're going to be trying to save someone's life to, you know, take a little bit of the anxiety out, but immediately get your hands. So make, you know, the palm of your hand, stick it on the center of the chest.
Center of chest in between the nipple line, we're calling it?
Yep, and then what you're gonna wanna do is hear the song in the background, Staying Alive, the Bee Gees. You're gonna wanna go to the beat of the song and go about 100 beats a minute, and you wanna press down about 2 to 3 inches, but importantly, you wanna have a good recoil on each, after each pressing of the chest.
What's a recoil?
So a recoil is when you press and the chest recoils like that.
It comes back up.
Because that's what allows the blood to flow into the heart. So that's very important during CPR.
While you do that, we gotta go ahead. That other person, we said, go find the AED. That person comes back, the AED is gonna tell you what to do.
So this is the AED. This is what we call a defibrillator. The first thing you wanna do with the AED is turn on the power button, just like so.
Nice and strong, it's gonna tell us.
And it's gonna tell you what to do, but usually what you wanna do first, apply the pads.
And check out on the pads, it's gonna show you exactly where to put them. So again, listen and watch, and you're gonna know how to do this. And you should not be afraid to do something, right?
Don't be afraid. So this is what can save a life, and it can happen anytime to any person at work. And if you do this, and if you listen and follow this, you might be able to save a life.
As we plugged this in, it said analyzing. So it's going to
It's actually checking for the heart rhythm to see if a shock is advised or not. And so this is telling us a shock is advised. So you press the button and it will deliver a shock, and that might be able to get the patient out of their cardiac arrest and save their life.
Very good. Guys, 70% of these incidents happen with no Dr. Senfield around, so we need you to know to act, to do something, right?
Very important, because you, if you do this, you know, might be able to save that life.
Thank you, sir. We appreciate it. I want everybody practicing CPR week, the last day. You might as well learn how to do it. Guys, you feel pretty confident?
Absolutely, exactly. And boy, you laid out so well there, both of you. Thanks so much, Christine.